Let's look into Mercedes-AMG's M129 engine, the sport version. We might as well just focus on one version here. And the reason here, and what prompted the existence of this video, is the fact that this engine not just produces an impressive power output of 210 horsepower per liter for a 500cc per cylinder four-cylinder engine, but also how Mercedes-AMG go about making it a fuel-efficient engine while at it. Some magazines has tested it at 34 miles per gallon, and Mercedes-AMG's own claim an average combined fuel consumption of 8.3 liters per 100 kilometer, which is 34 miles per gallon worldwide, or 28.3 American miles per gallon, all on a 420 horsepower car that is four-wheel drive and weighs 1.6 tons, which is mighty impressive. Combined CO2 emissions of 189 grams per kilometer. Some basic specs first. The M139 engine found on the 2019 Mercedes-AMG A45 A45S is a 2-liter 4-cylinder direct and indirect fuel injection twin scroll turbo charged cooled engine, or water to air cooled. It uses aluminium alloy for the block, utilizing a method called chilled cast with water cool casting methods to cool the material quickly, and somehow its alloy molecules could form better homogeneity when it solidifies. The engine bore and stroke is under square, with a 0.921 bore to stroke ratio. It has double overhead cam, 16 valve with two stage variable cam profile on its exhaust, called camtronic, with cam timing adjustments for the intake valves. This time around, for the A45S, Mercedes-AMG has turned the cylinder head around from its predecessor, the M133, now having its intake facing forwards and exhaust rearwards. So where is Mercedes-AMG's party trick? Maybe we could start off with it being a frugal engine first. Looking at a 4-valve per cylinder combustion chamber design, one thing that stands out is that it does not resemble anything like a high-performance 4-valve per cylinder arrangement, but more akin to one that belongs to an economical petrol-powered engine. The intake valve is small compared to the potential available space, and more importantly, aligned further towards the outer radius of the cylinder, closer to the edge of the combustion chamber rather than towards the center, closer to the spark plug. Valves that are aligned closer to the center offer more width, so the larger valves can be used, as seen here on the Aishko-tuned Mercedes-AMG M156 cylinder head. Interestingly, this also shows that the Mercedes-AMG GT's M156 engine is actually quite different from the A45's M139, even though they share the same 500cc per cylinder size from the same manufacturer. Like on more economical engines, the small valve used on the M139 will offer better low-end power, and its smaller volume will result in higher intake velocity at low speeds that will contribute to a healthy low-end swirl. This will contribute to better fuel economy also, for having better mixture charge given the fuel used. With this, the variable cams and having an under-square bore to stroke ratio, while its direct injection provides stratified charge, this combination is typical of a contemporary economical internal combustion petrol-powered plant. Well, then of course, the thing is, a typical modern-day economical internal combustion petrol engine does not make 210 horsepower per liter or 420 horsepower for 2 liters. Even the most powerful turbocharged supercars or even hypercars do not achieve this, albeit maybe a few specialist manufacturers. So where does all this power come from on a rather efficient engine? Well, the explanation may be a bit of a cliche and quite blunt, although the method of how they go about it is where it makes a difference. They simply rely heavily on turbo boost. 29 pounds per square inch, or 2 bars of boost on the A45, and 31 pounds per square inch, or 2.1 bar of boost on the A45S, or the sport variant of this engine. However, that difference has its complexities that lie on the engine block. Apparently, it is very strong. According to Mercedes-AMG's head of engine development, Ralph Ellenberger, it is comparable to a diesel block and takes 160 bars peak pressure. One wonders if that chill casting method of making the M139's block comes centered around this strength. The fuel injection system does not only come with direct injection, but also with an indirect injection system when volume is needed. Another interesting aspect of this engine is its cam drive. Its cam drive is where the flywheel is located, rather than where the ancillaries belt drives are. Not quite normal for a production engine, and seen more on racing engines. Wonder if this has anything to do with trying to reduce crankshaft resonance or vibration from those high cylinder pressures in conjunction to a peak RPM of 7,200. It would also mean most of the engine load and stress would be on one side of the engine where output is, the stronger part of the engine, so crank would merely have to turn that end without getting into complications, again, such as resonance. On the M133, the previous model, the cam drive is where the ancillary belt drives are. So there is a big difference here between these two engines. Another thing to note is the camtronic twin profile cam on the exhaust. Most manufacturers who only use one side as variable cam profile or twin profile usually have it on the intake, but this time Mercedes-AMG has it on the exhaust. This is not quite contemporary. Having said that, could this be Mercedes-AMG engineering early turbocharged spooling together with an electrically controlled boost gauge? Could it be a subtle anti-lag system maybe? If so, this can be compared to an anti-lag system that delays ignition firing. What would happen is the ignition is delayed to a point where the exhaust valve is about to open, and when ignition is fired late, exhaust valve would open with the charge still being burnt, and this would cause the burning charge to escape through the exhaust towards the turbo's turbine and spin it to boost. A reverse method would be to have the exhaust valve open in advance or early. While burning is still occurring, the exhaust valve would open early and release this pressure buildup towards the turbo's turbine to assist spinning the turbo. So could this be what they are doing? An exhaust that has variable cam profile, utilizing the larger profile to spool the turbo and then revert to a normal cam profile once boost is up. Saab used to tune the exhaust to open early and assist in low-end turbo spool up. The M139 engine is all about numbers, and it looks like they have gone through a lot to make them impressive. The M139 engine certainly shows that Mercedes-AMG did not compromise on it, and it probably is one of the most engineering-focused petrol engine, as it has to deliver for the best of both worlds. Another interesting and much talked about or written aspect of the A45S is its rear differential, or if it actually has one. The A45S has drift mode, and a lot of it centers on this differential. This unit has a solid final drive without any differential gear set, and instead has two sets of clutch, one for each wheel, a bit like on the Ferrari FF's front drive, yeah? What this does is, it gives the electronics full control of each rear wheel, giving all rear drive to one wheel while the other wheel is turned off, or locking the rear wheels together as if there is no differential, like on a go-kart. There shouldn't be any worry though of the clutch slipping, even though it sits right in between the powertrain and wheel, because all it needs to do is be stronger than the rear wheel's grip, and slipping won't be an issue.